Pioneer probes, you probably know. They are the ones who have taken on board engraved gold plates intended for possible extraterrestrials, like bottles thrown into the sea. But what is the anomaly of the Pioneer probes, and how to explain it? Launched in 1972 and 1973, the Pioneer 10 and 11 probes were launched into space. After having passed the orbit of Uranus, at 20 astronomical units, that is to say at 20 times the distance from the Sun to the Earth, and while their trajectory was no longer corrected by engines, an anomaly on their speed was detected in 1979 by NASA, a stronger deceleration than expected. And once detected, this strange unexplained deceleration phenomenon persisted. What is this mystery? Let's go back to the circumstances of the tragedy, the clues found, the technical elements. A bit of physics. By definition, an acceleration is the derivative with respect to time of the velocity. Let's call AI the acceleration, with I for inertial. In practice, as it is difficult to measure an instantaneous derivative, we measure the speed at two close instants and we then obtain the average acceleration over this period of time. Thanks to the relativistic redshift formula which converts the received frequency into speed, we can calculate the average deceleration AI. Moreover, by sending from the Earth in the direction of the probe an electromagnetic wave which is re-emitted at another frequency by the probe towards the Earth, and knowing that this electromagnetic wave moves at the speed of light c, we thus know at how far away the probe is at a given time. We can then calculate the gravitational attraction AG of the Sun and the other planets on this probe. The only known external force acting on the probe is gravity G. We must therefore have AI equals AG. And it was Dr. John Anderson who found the body I know, a gap between AI and AG. The difference is extremely small, 0.01% difference. We will obviously assume that no one was wrong in making the calculations that have been checked and rechecked and re-rechecked. And if the difference came, not from the calculations, but from the formulas used. To calculate AG, we used the classic law of gravity at 1 over R2. And if this law was false at great distance, and that it was transformed for example into 1 on R, this is the track followed by the MUND theory of Mordehai-Milgram, which is based on another law of gravity at great distance. The concern is that the classic law of gravitation in 1 on R2 appears to work well on even more distant objects, such as the stars of our galaxy. The track is not very promising. Another track could be the effect of another external force. A few have looked into the supposed expansion of space itself, the effect of which could be likened to some other external force. But even relativists do not give much credence to this assumption. Yet another track, there would be a complementary acceleration of internal origin to the probe, which we will call AC, which would explain the difference. It was Slova Tarashev, from Professor Anderson's team, who found the clue, a flux of infrared photons emitted from the heat engine and directed forwards which would slow down the probe. Since 2011, this has been the official explanation. What do you say? That you talked to your wife about it, and she watched two videos against relativistic redshift. A first video that said that this forces us to consider the existence of galaxies that would go faster than the speed of light, which is curious. And a second video which showed that the relativistic demonstration of the redshift would be approximate. And so, what do you conclude? The culprit would then rather be the relativistic formula of redshift. It would have been necessary to use the neo-Newtonian formula, which gives exactly the difference observed. The error would therefore not be in the calculation of the acceleration, but in the calculation of the speed. Very strong. Ah, I almost forgot something important. What? Well, to communicate my sources.